ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله. In reading the المحنة الربانية في شرح الأربعين النووية by فضيلة العلامة الشيخ صالح الفوزان حفظه الله تبارك وتعالى. And ما زلنا في الحديث الثاني. We still, alhamdulillah, reading the second hadith, which is the hadith of Ibn Umar, Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu. قال بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم إذ طلع علينا رجل شديد بياد الثياب شديد سواد الشعر لا يرى عليه أثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على خفذيه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا قال صدقت قال فعجبنا له يسأله ويصدقه قال فأخبرني عن الإيمان قال أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره قال صدقت قال فأخبرني عن الإحسان قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك قال فأخبرني عن الساعة قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها قال أن تلد الأمة ربتها وأن ترى الحفاة العراة عالة الرعاء الشاء يتطاولون في البنيان قال ثم انطلق فلبثت مليا ثم قال لي يا عمر أتدري من السائل قلت الله ورسوله أعلم قال فإنه جبريل آتاكم يعلمكم دينكم رواه مسلم. So this hadith, the second hadith of Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه, as Imam al-Nawawi رحمه الله تبارك وتعالى mentioned. And in mentioning first and foremost, as Sheikh Fawzan حفظه الله, in explaining this hadith, he first and foremost, بارك الله فيكم, mentioned that from the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is that he used to sit among the Sahaba. And the Sahaba, they used to be asking questions to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Sheikh Fawzan hafidhullah, he say, وَيَسْتَرْشِدُونَ مِنْهُ, and they were seeking guidance from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَيَسْأَلُونَهُ عَنْ أُمُورِ دِينِهِمْ, and they used to ask him about the affairs of their religion. And likewise, the Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam, Sheikh Fawzan, he described how Jibreel came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the best hay'ah, in the best mannerism, in the best appearance, whereas his garment was very clean and his hair was very, alhamdulillah, dark. And this is a good appearance that he came with. And likewise, he came with discipline, with respect to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, haythu he didn't just come and then ask the question from a mile away, but rather he came until he sat down in front of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he sat down with discipline and he sat down with respect, and humility by way of putting his knees on the knees of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and putting his own hands on his own thighs, and he say to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, akhbirni anil Islam, inform me of what is Islam. So the Shaykh hafizahullah ta'ala, he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned these five pillars of al-Islam, and he used the word arkan. He used the word arkanul Islam. And as we read barakallahu fikum last week, that the wording of the word, yani the statement of arkan, it is not something that is found in the nusus. The word arkan here, arkanul Islam and arkanul Iman, these are two istilahat that are different. These are two wording that are different, because if we say the arkanul Islam, it is the same, meaning the word arkan in here, it is the same as the word arkan in Iman. Then if a person abandon that which is the Hajj or the Siyam, then we will say the same thing if a person abandon believing in the Malaika. Because believing in the Malaika is one of the arkanul Iman. So therefore he mentioned, as Shaykh Muhammad Ibrahim Ali Shaykh Rahimahullah mentioned in his explanation, that the wording of the istilahat of al-arkan, it is different, but rather we go back to the text, to the nusus, to understand what is the meaning of arkan in here. Here in arkan al-Islam, that it is known that if a person, yani he does not perform the hajj deliberately, or he does not perform the siyam, sawm ramadan deliberately, طيب, without disbelieving in the obligation of it, then he is not يُعْتَبَر لَا يُعْتَبَر بِأَنَّهُ كَافِرًا. He is not to be seen as a disbeliever. But if a person yani deliberately disbelieve in the malaika or in the books, then صَارَ كَافِرًا, he is a disbeliever. So you realize the word arkan in the arkanul Islam and the word arkan in the arkanul Iman, it goes back to the text to understand what is the meaning of al-arkan. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, yani answered Jibreel of what was al-Islam. And likewise, Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam asked again, what is al-Iman? So today, bi-ithnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, the Shaykh rahimahullahu ta'ala, he mentioned, and we're going to be reading in page number 46. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as the Shaykh he say, thumma sa'alahu an al-iman, and afterward Jibril alayhi salatu wasalam asked the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam about al-iman. Faqala akhbirni an al-iman, and he asked him, what is, inform me of al-iman. So if one asks us, is the same word arkan in Islam, take the same meaning as the word arkan in iman, then we will say that it is different. The same way, barakallahu feekum, that which will establish Islam is different from what will establish al-Iman. So he mentioned the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Jibril alayhi salatu wasalam, he say, akhbirni an al-Iman, inform me of al-Iman, meaning belief and faith. Faqala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, an tu'mina billahi, it is that you believe in Allah. وملائكته in the angels, وكتبه in the books, ورسله in the messengers, واليوم الآخر in the last day, وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره, and you believe in the qadr, the predestination, the good and the bad of it. Shaykh Fawzan حفظه الله, he say الإيمان, فالإيمان هو هذه أركان الباطنة. He said that al-Iman, it is those pillars that are the inward pillars. That are the inward pillars. So therefore we understand from that, from the definition of al-Islam, it is al-Islam, when he mentioned those five things, then this was the outwardly pillar. So he mentioned al-Iman, huwa hadhihi al-arkan al-batina. This is this inwardly, yani pillars. And he said, now he's given what is the meaning of al-Iman in the language. And then, alhamdulillah, bring what is al-Iman in that which is the Sharia, based on the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Because, لا تخفى عليكم, as it is not hidden from you, that you have many deviant groups that is that are out there that are having their own definition, تعريفات الإيمان. So the Shaykh حفظه الله say الإيمان وهو في اللغة in the Arabic language it is التصديق الجازم الذي لا يعتري شك. The meaning of الإيمان in the language. The meaning of الإيمان in the language. It is التصديق الجازم الذي لا يعتريه شك. It is that يعني belief or that testification or that affirmation, that due affirmation, the due testification that is not touched by any types of doubts. It is that testification, that affirmation that is not touched by any type of doubts, meaning the individual, alaykum salam, tullahi barakatuh. The person testify about one thing and he doesn't have no doubt, right? He testify about a matter and he doesn't have no doubt, yani that which about he is testifying. So this is in the Arabic language. Now, amma fi shar' as in regard to the sharia, حفظه الله ورعاه say, الإيمان فهو قول باللسان. It is the statement of the tongue. واعتقاد بالقلب. And it is the faith or the belief in the heart. It is اعتقاد بالقلب. It is the belief in the heart. وعمل الجوارح. And the actions of the body limbs. طيب. يزيد بالطاعة وينقص بالمعصية. It increases with acts of obedience and it decreases with the acts of disobedience. Now you have a group or few groups that agree with part of this statement of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah in the Ta'rif al-Iman. Who are those that believe that al-Iman is qawlun bil-lisan, اعتقاد بالقلب وعمل بالجوارح. He say the murji'ah. The khawarij, yes. The khawarij, they say that al-Iman, it is qawlun bil-lisan, just like Ahlu Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Qawlun bil-lisan, عمل بالجوارح, طيب, واعتقاد بالقلب. طيب, qawlun bil-lisan, عمل الجوارح واعتقاد بالقلب. This is it, that's what, for a stop. طيب, and who else? طيب, the murji'ah, and likewise, you have those who, barakallahu feekum, they say that the iman, the individual, whether he is a Muslim, he's a believer or he's not a believer, right? Meaning he is not in anywhere. طيب, he's not in anywhere. Meaning he is not, يعني, if he's commit a sin, يعني, a kaba'ir and the like, then this is not to place him in the ranks of the believer. طيب. But amma, you have the khawarij, barakallahu feekum, they will not be, they believe this three things. But amma yazidu bita'a wa yanqusu bil ma'asi aw bil ma'siya, they left that off. And the Shaykh hafidhahu Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he mentioned that this is the murji'ah, they have a different istilahat. But amma the Mu'tazila, this is also what they believe. This is what they said. The Mu'tazila and likewise the Khawarij. They believe that Iman, it is i'tiqadun bil qalb. Or likewise, yani establishment of the body limbs. And likewise, an-nutqu bil lisan. But amma the Murji'ah, they say something else. So the Shaykh hafidhahu Allah, he say, هذا هو الإيمان عند أهل السنة والجماعة. These five things. يعني the statement of the tongue, the belief of the heart, the action of the limbs, increasing with obedience and decreasing with acts of disobedience. He say that this is what is known of al-Iman with Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. He say khilafan lil murji'ah, in opposition of the murji'ah. And the word of the murji'ah, barakallahu feekum, as we have mentioned, it comes, yani the ulama they mentioned, it comes, yani, by way of one of these two. طيب, al-irja, or that word, ar-